Hello, everybody. I am Timmy Jenkins. If you say one thing that'll ruin this, I'll kill you. Right, introduce yourselves because I don't feel like it.
Hi, I'm Lion, that animal from Africa.
And I am Cosmic Waffles.
Yeah, you're new, aren't you?
Well, I'm like original OG that's new to this.
Remember when we called you an intern?
Yeah, I was permanent intern, dude.
Yeah.
I've been at YouTube since before you guys was born.
I was in the womb when I was doing my YouTube.
I came out with a camera and a keyboard in my hand.
Exactly.
No, that's not what a YouTuber would have. A YouTuber would say, I came out there with a camera and a beanie.
A beanie.
I don't wear a beanie though.
Yeah, but hipsters are a lot. There are a lot of hipster YouTubers. Anyway, that's not what we're talking about at all. Okay, Happy New Year, everybody. To
I
all the
wouldn't
people
say
watching, and to.
I wouldn't say happy, but okay.
I wouldn't say happy, but okay.
Okay, everybody, sad New Year. Everybody, just go back to living in 2015.
Yep.
2016 is gonna be horrible.
It is
every
Let's
year
just
from
give up.
here.
I just want to
It's gonna
say. I
be.
want to say. By the way, I have a New Year's resolution. All right.
What is your
One,
New Year's resolution?
I have several, but one of them is to get 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year
By the
on
end of the
YouTube.
year?
Yeah. I know
Okay.
it's a big goal, but I'm hoping with the help of everyone that I can achieve that. Because, everyone only has to worry about me. But yeah, I'm hoping you, the subscribers, can help in some way. That would be nice.
I see. I'd just be happy if I made it to 100 by the end of the year.
Just make a Patreon page and ask every one of your subscribers to do so.
Patreon page just
Yeah, and then ask every one of your subscribers to donate 50 cents. You'd make a lot of money.
dude, that's what I'm making a month off of YouTube anyway. Not actually, but well, maybe I'm not gonna say. I'm not allowed to say.
I'm not allowed to say how much I make on YouTube.
You're not actually, you're legally not allowed to say.
Something new every day.
Okay, yeah. So we're gonna be talking about, since it's the new year, we're gonna be talking about our favorite
It's the new
thing
year?
because yeah, it is. Because we're much better than every other podcast in the world. Not true, by the way.
I think it's pretty true.
Aw.
I would argue it. I
Aw,
mean,
you think you could really argue that?
yes.
Realistically.
Yes.
If you could, that would be an interesting debate. I would love to see that.
Because we're awesome.
Yeah, anyway,
Done.
so because we're much better than all the podcasts in the world, which is up for debate, we are going to be talking about our favorite things, not of 2015, but ever. So basically, we can talk about anything we like, any single thing. So, Lion, let's start with you. What's something that you love, that you would want love to talk about?
Honestly, Daggerfall. The
What?
second game to the Elder Scrolls series.
Okay. Aren't
That was like one of the first games I ever played. It's my
cool.
favorite.
Cool. Well,
Oh
cosmic
yeah, you
cos
guys sound so enthused.
enthused. Yeah, we're really enthused.
I've never played Daggerfall, so I can't have input
I don't
on
e
that.
I've never even heard of it before, so I can't say anything about it. Okay, Waffles, why don't you say something?
I think one of the like most enjoyable things for me was finding like
Do
a
not
couple
say
YouTube
YouTube.
channels that I really liked enjoying watching, not like recording or anything, but I like a few channels that really made me laugh back in the day.
All right. Cool. Very good answer. Mine is actually an anime series that I just recently started watching. And it's and I gotta thank CP Hicks for recommending this to me. Well, he didn't recommend it, but he said it was his favorite show ever, and I had to watch it because of that reason. Because he is the joy of my life, not really. But so it's called Black Butler. Have you ever heard of it?
Yeah, I heard it.
Okay, it's good. It's actually like really good compared to what I thought. By the end of the first season, I was like, oh man, the feels. The feels are flying. The feels are flying.
I really hope that that word is like eradicated from the English dictionary.
The feels?
Yeah, the feels.
Why?
It's not even a real word. It's not even in the dictionary.
Well, it's not one word. It's the feels. It's two words, technically.
Yeah, it's like feels like he feels with the article the.
The feels. So basically, you're butchering sentence structure, not actual language.
Dude, okay, you're talking about a culture that uses the term LOL in everyday life.
Which actually stands for something literate. Lot of laughs.
Lot of laughs. Okay. Now, all right.
Enough of that. Let's move on.
Yeah. Okay. So now here's the catch. After we say something we loved, we're gonna say something we really dislike.
Okay. I already have one.
Okay.
Should I say it?
Yeah. Say it.
Call of Duty Ghosts.
Okay. I have a question. I didn't play it, but why did everyone hate Call of Duty Ghosts?
Because it was shit.
But by the way, PG-13.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, but why? Like, what was wrong with it?
Okay, so they take, like, you know, this whole futuristic thing that they're going with, and then they send you all the way back to, like, regular weapons, and nothing's really cool about the characters, and those dogs were OP as anything. When you called in a dog, if, like, you killed someone and their dog was alive, you just had to, like, run to Mexico, because that dog was coming after you. And then there was this stupid thing where, like, if you were in a gunfight and you got shot once, you were pretty much done, like, dead for.
Tactical nuke!
Yeah, you couldn't, like, turn around and win the gun battle, you were just done.
Yeah. It seems like, I think they tried to correct that with the Black Ops 3, it seems like, due to how, like, it seems like the more the Call of Duty games have advanced, it's more like, okay, add more movement capabilities, like, more ways to traverse things, so that way you can... It's not quite as... One thing that I didn't like about Call of Duty was how it was very linear. You know, it's like very... It was very much...
Yeah.
If the guy got the drop on you, you lose.
Yeah.
Like that's just it, you know?
And most of them were like... I mean, I love the Call of Duty games, but most of them are just copy and pastes of the other ones.
Yeah. I'm glad you can accept that. You know, every person that I've talked to who loves Call of Duty is like, nah, man, they're all different. It's like, this one has, you know, robots. And a robot dog, and it's like, yeah, you know, it's different, but but here's the thing, I don't blame people though who like it. I'm not saying it's wrong to like it, because it, like, okay, I was talking about to Lion about this earlier about Far Cry 4. He doesn't want to get Far Cry 4, by the way, because he thinks that it's just a copy and paste of all the other Far Cry games, which, seeing other Far Cry games, I will agree with, but I think the thing to remember is that it's a formula. And that it works.
And if it works, they're going to milk it.
And there's nothing necessarily wrong with that, because it's just like, if it's fun, then it's fun, you know? It's like, so what if it's the same experience over and over again? I mean, if people are getting tired of it, when people get tired of it, they'll change it, you know?
Yeah. And that's what happened with Call of Duty, is that they realized they couldn't keep doing what they were doing, and they had to start adding these crazy movement devices.
And the weird, like, Cthulhu zombie mode.
Yeah, I don't even understand where that came from.
But, dude, that is so cool, because I love H.P. Lovecraft. Mm. So it's like, oh, man, like, this is like Cthulhu Call of Duty, which is awesome.
Yeah, where you turn into a Japanese tentacle monster. Couldn't imagine what happens next.
Exactly.
Okay, what's something you hated, Lion, of all of time?
Of all time?
Yeah.
This can be anything, right?
It can be anything. It could be like, you could just say Obama, and that's it.
Social justice warriors.
Social justice workers?
Warriors.
Warriors. Oh, as in the people on the internet who have to make sure that everyone has social justice?
Yeah, I mean, go to Tumblr and you'll find, like, their hideout.
their
hideout. Like, yeah, they're like a terrorist cell. That's how you
and
you'll find them.
You'll find those people.
Along with feminists. Like 40-year-old feminists.
See, I don't have a problem with the whole feminist thing. I think it's crazy when like there's an extreme feminist. Then it gets a little too much.
I have a big problem with feminism. Big Red. I have a big problem with feminism.
Teddy, you gotta stop, man. They're gonna tear you up in the comments.
Dude, do you see the Donald Trump video I made?
No.
I can't get much more torn up. Plus, I actually got some really good feedback from that video.
Did you say you like Donald Trump?
Hey,
go watch the video, okay? Don't say anything until you see the video.
Did you?
Like I said, though, dude, I have like 5 likes on that video, just so you know.
It's good. Good to hear.
Oh, shut up. Just leave it alone, okay? But yeah, I don't get... I just... What's the purpose of feminism now?
World domination. that was a joke.
Yeah, I know. I understand. But what's the point? Because women have all the rights that men do.
They want extra rights, but when they get treated equally, they want to retreat back and say that they're frail women.
You know, that's interesting, though, isn't it? That often I see people saying, you should treat a woman just like you would a man. But then when it's like, if there's a news story where a dude hits a woman in the face, it's like, oh, that's horrible. You know?
But if a girl slapped a guy in the face, then it's like, oh, it's he deserved it.
Yeah, yeah.
Slapping is okay. Hitting, balling up your fist.
No.
Yeah, but I mean, like, even if a guy slapped a girl,
like, okay, there's tons of stories out there where, like, a girl gets mad at her boyfriend, so she, like, I don't know, chops his hand off or something, and everybody's like, oh, well, okay. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. People don't really care when it's a dude.
It's like, well, that's crazy. What's the next story?
Yeah. But it's like, okay, if a woman is, I don't know, held hostage and killed, it's like, that's significantly more horrible than a dude getting killed. Which, I mean, I'm not saying that I have a problem with that. I'm just saying I have a problem with people saying that women should be treated just like men. Like, okay, if... Because, I mean, I don't know. I'm tired of arguing about this. I made a whole... There's another video I have just about feminism in gaming that I'm releasing. Okay, anyway, I guess I have to talk about... So, can I just skip my turn since I basically just talked about feminism? About how much I hate feminism.
I guess
that
is counts. That the one thing you hated of all time is feminism?
I mean, there's multiple things I hate, but this is like right now. Like, we'll probably do this again next year, and it'll be something totally different. I mean,
complain about me hating things.
Okay. So, something we love again. All right, Lion, go. Something you love.
Something I love. That's a toughie.
There's not many things I open my heart to in this world.
No. I mean, there's many things. I just can't choose.
Well, just the first thing that pops into your head, like, you know, we got to talk about this for like an hour, so.
Okay. I suppose it would be, Fallout in general.
All right.
That's a good answer.
All right.
Fallout.
Are all of your answers going to be video games? Not saying there's anything wrong with that. I'm just curious.
No. I got a few things off the top of my head that don't
okay. Games. Okay.
I'm just saying that is way up there.
Now, is it Fallout the original or Fallout 4?
All of them, honestly.
Okay.
Of the franchise.
Except for Tactics and Brotherhood of Steel.
You're just thankful for the franchise, is what you're saying. You're just thankful that is a game that exists, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay. I can understand that.
My favorite is obviously Fallout 4. It brings a lot of new things to the table.
Lays them on a plate.
Yeah, pretty much. But the character creation system is hilarious because there have been many people who've made celebrities.
Yeah, I've seen those.
I've seen people like make like Vin Diesel and Kim Kardashian. I'm like,
my favorite was when someone made Hitler.
Yeah, I was about to say that's the one I saw.
I saw that one too.
And his wife was Anne Frank.
Oh gosh.
That was so perfectly synced.
That is a horrible thing to do. Shame on whoever.
Oh, don't be an SJW.
What does that even mean?
a social justice warrior.
No, I'm not saying that.
I'm joking.
Okay.
I'm joking.
Okay, because I was just like, don't make jokes about. I get that people, you know, it's a long time ago, but still, I don't necessarily feel okay with people making Hitler jokes, you know, like Anne Frank jokes and stuff like that. I mean, I just, like, that was some bad stuff, you know, like.
Learn to laugh.
If you went back in that time, people weren't, like, laughing about it, you know? Like, that's the equivalent of somebody making, like, a 9/11 joke now.
I've seen plenty of those.
I know, and I hate those more because, I mean, that's like now, and that's like
dead baby jokes.
That probably the equivalent of everything that we said. So equivalent of Hitler, equivalent of 9/11. I mean, I get that it's just what I'm trying to like. What am I doing?
I don't even know.
I don't know. I'm like trying to say which is worse, Hitler jokes, 9/11 jokes, or dead baby jokes. It's like I don't.
Let's move it on.
Okay, yeah. So I was about to say Hitler.
What?
I was about to call you Hitler Waffles.
Wow.
I had Hitler. Thanks. No, I had Hitler.
Guess I understand your true feelings towards me now. Wow.
No. See, this is why I haven't called you in so long.
Because secretly you think I'm the embodiment of Hitler.
Oh, yeah, man. Although, you've seen those theories about how Hitler's still alive.
Oh, yeah.
They're true. Every one of them are true.
Okay.
So this is another thing I like, right?
Another thing you like.
Well, since it came out recently, I've been really into the Star Wars again. So the movies.
Oh, yes, man. Did you like the new Star Wars movie?
Yeah, I liked Episode 7. I thought it was good.
Yeah.
I had a friend spoil it for me, though, so I was kind of mad.
Oh, that would have been horrible, dude.
Did you guys see the story about the guy that went out into the lobby and spoiled it for everyone, and he got savagely beaten by a woman?
Yeah, I heard about that.
He got beaten?
Yeah.
And he got sent into intensive care unit because of it.
Are you serious? Who beat him?
Like someone dressed up as Boba Fett, someone dressed up as Chewbacca, and someone dressed up as a stormtrooper.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I heard about a guy
there's a video of it, isn't there?
I guess. I wouldn't.
There's probably a video. Why am I laughing? That guy got sent to intensive care. I mean, I know, but it's kind of funny that, okay, imagine you were the one who got beaten up by Boba Fett.
He didn't deserve
it. I would not be laughing if I was the one who got beaten up.
I'd never
spoil anything ever again.
Yeah, I know, but you would feel like such a loser because you got beaten up by a whole bunch of nerds. You know, I'm sorry, but really, if you gotta get beaten up by somebody, it's like Star Wars fans are getting beaten up.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. I think he deserved to get a few knocks to the head, but not enough to where he needs to be sent to intensive care.
Not to where it's like he could die.
Yeah, like the doctor walks in, what happened to him? Did you get hit by a car? No, I got beat up by a bunch of Star Wars characters.
No, Chewie messed him up real good.
Yeah.
All right. Now.
Okay, something I love, I guess. Something I really love. Something that I really, really love. Okay, I did read there. Okay, there is one thing that in particular that I really, really liked. I've started reading a bunch of the Star Wars books. And I read one that I'm not sure if you read this one, Will, before. Waffles. I should call you Waffles. I probably haven't because
I don't read the comics or the graphic novels about them or anything.
I'm not sure. Well, it's this one called, I think it's called Lords of the Sith, I think is what it's called. And it was really interesting. It's about like this freedom fighter on this planet. It's during the Empire's occupation of the galaxy, and before Luke Skywalker is you know, Luke Skywalker. Yeah.
Post Order 66.
Yeah, it's post Order 66, but before A New Hope, and so it's about this one freedom fighter trying to save his planet. And so what happens is that he gets word that the Emperor and Darth Vader are coming to his planet on their his own personal Star Destroyer. So he comes up with this big plan of how he's going to try to kill him and blow up Star Destroyer and kill Darth Vader. And dude, it is so cool because it reminds me in a lot of ways of, like, you know, the Valkyrie mission in World War II?
Yeah.
They made a movie about it. Tom Cruise played the guy with the eye patch.
Yeah.
It reminds me a lot of that. It was really cool because it's like this one dude who's like, we gotta kill this guy. Like, if we fail, then we're all just gonna die anyway. You know, like, so it's very interesting. I won't spoil the ending or anything or what happens, but it's
well, really, I mean, Darth Vader obviously doesn't die.
Yes, or the Emperor, but it's interesting because it also shows more of what Darth Vader and the Emperor are like. Their relationship is like,
because
it shows a lot of, and it taught me something I didn't know about the Emperor. Did you know that the Emperor basically just knows everything?
What?
Like, he can sense. Like... So get this, I didn't know this. So like every Sith Lord has a force kind of
sensitive,
not like a specialized force thing though. So yeah, for instance, like Darth Vader's is kind of being able to let the force use his body to do whatever, you know, like for instance, that's why he's such a good pilot, you know, is because he lets the force flow through him and control every action that he has and stuff like that. It's stuff that's his thing, but and that was also kind of like Luke's thing too.
The Emperor's is the laser hands.
No. So the Emperor's is he can basically sense anything that he needs to. For instance, he could know whatever Darth Vader's thinking.
Wow.
Like without. Like, just by sensing it. And you know how, like, there are times when he does that in the movies, too. Like, you know how the Emperor senses that Luke Skywalker is alive?
Yeah.
Like, stuff like that. Like, he can do stuff
like... You mean Anakin?
No. Luke. When the Emperor... Oh, you know how in the first movie, the Emperor comes contacts him and says, the son of Anakin Skywalker is alive. And he's like, okay. Which is weird, by the way, because he doesn't flip out and go like, wait, you mean my son's alive? I have a son?
Well, I think at that point in Anakin / Darth's head, I think at that point he thinks of Anakin Skywalker as being dead.
I think he does too. I think he thinks of himself as, I'm not Anakin Skywalker, I'm Darth Vader.
Darth Vader.
Yeah.
Hey, and, do you remember in episode 2, I think? No, it was episode 3, where he was about to kill Count Dooku and the Emperor was like, do it.
Okay. Yeah, and then Anakin's like, "No, I really shouldn't."
It's not the Jedi way,
dude. Yeah, and then he's just like, "Do it."
Okay,
and he does.
Okay, like, let's. What? I just want to talk. Okay, we're moving on to something that we hate. Something I hate is all the prequel Star Wars movies.
I don't hate
that. Episode 1 is better than Episode 7.
They're not my favorite.
That's a terrible thing to say, because here's something that I really don't like, is the way that Anakin becomes Darth Vader.
Okay. Yeah.
So for instance, all right, we've talked about this on the podcast before, but so Anakin goes from being like a Jedi, just a good guy, to then he decides to kill Mace Windu.
He doesn't try to kill Mace Windu.
Yeah,
though.
But after that, he's like, I swear allegiance to you, Emperor. After accidentally killing Mace Windu.
Yeah, that's a weird thing.
And then he goes and murders a whole bunch of children.
Yeah, that was crazy.
How does that transition make sense?
He does that because he wants to save his
wife. Shut up.
Yeah, he wants to save Padme.
But okay,
and the only way he is going to save Padme is if he teams up with the Emperor, because the Emperor was like, I'll teach you how to keep someone alive, even though the Emperor doesn't know.
But still, that's a weird... Like, I don't know if you can... Like, I don't get why... Okay, and another thing. He then tries to kill Padme. And then... She dies, and he stays with the Emperor.
Yeah, because at that point, he's got nothing left to fight for or to live for.
Yeah, why not just kill the Emperor?
I should say Anakin Skywalker has nothing left to live for, but he could take over this new life as Darth Vader. You know?
No. I'm sorry, I just had to break the silence.
I was like, what happened to Teddy?
Teddy died.
Teddy's gone. Yeah, I don't know. That's my feelings on that, though.
Okay, I'm back.
He's back.
Okay. But yeah, Star Wars, the prequels are pretty insane.
I have to admit, though, I do love the fight scene between Obi-Wan and Anakin at the very end on, like, the lava planet.
You gotta admit, though, it's very cartoony. That's a very
it is cartoony.
Because, if you look at the fight, they're doing, like, 360s and continuing to fight each other. And it's like, this is so choreographed. Like, people couldn't really fight like this. That's one reason I love the fight between Darth Vader and Luke in Empire Strikes Back when they're in the Carbonite Room, is because they're fighting like, you know, I'm holding something that could chop my arm off. Not like, oh, let me just do this little dance.
I mean, I just love the part at the very end when he's like, "You were the chosen one."
Yeah. Okay. So something that I noticed, somebody else noticed, and I noticed it as well. When Obi-Wan says, "I have the high ground," and he then chops off all of his limbs.
I know, that's so messed up.
And then, but okay,
he slices both his legs and an arm.
Okay, but get this. Here's the. You remember in Phantom Menace, Obi-Wan.
I hate you.
Obi-Wan doesn't have the high ground when he's beneath Darth Maul, and he then flips over him and grabs a lightsaber and chops him in half.
Yeah.
How does that make sense? That's like saying
Darth Maul was just not very skilled, I guess.
Well, you know, Darth Maul is alive technically in canon.
He was like, what? He just flipped over me. Oh, I'm dead.
Yeah. Okay. What's something else that you guys really don't like? Or you guys just want to say that we all don't like the prequels?
I mean, I don't. It's not that I don't like them. I don't like them as much as the originals.
See, I just have so many problems with it. I think that's it may just be me and like a slow spawn's critical attitude of things. Cuz I mean, it might just be that you guys are more like more casual fans about it than
I really hate Anita Sarkeesian.
Who?
Anita Sarkeesian.
Who is that?
I have no clue. How do you not know who Anita Sarkeesian is?
There are many ways that we would not know who that is.
Did I know?
You're saying you hate feminism, but you don't know who Anita Sarkeesian is. She owns Feminist Frequency and has attacked the gaming world so many times.
Oh, is it that lady?
Yeah.
And I've heard about that.
I hate her because she's fake.
Okay, let's not let's not use the word hate a person. Okay, let's say the word we dislike that person.
No, because hating,
I feel, is a bit strong, and you cannot take that back.
Yeah, hate is a strong word.
Yeah. Continue.
So is love.
Love is also a very strong word.
But guess what? That's why we don't say, I go around, I love this person. You know, we say, I like this person. You know, because love is too strong of a word. Anyway, just go on. Okay, complain about your feminism, person.
You complain about your feminist.
You don't give me that. You complained about feminism in the beginning of this
video. Yeah, but you're complaining about a person.
Who is a feminist.
Okay, I'll complain about a person in a few minutes.
Okay, well,
just go ahead and say it.
She was attacking the new Doom game and Fallout 4 because it was, and I don't like her because of Fallout 4. She's attacking all the gory games.
Dude, were you trying to clarify, say that I'm not mad at her just because she hates Fallout 4?
No, I'm clarifying that I don't like her just because of that.
Okay,
go ahead. She attacks all the gory games. Mm-hmm. Yet, earlier, before that, she took a picture with a big stack of games. One of them was Prototype 2. One of them was Gears of War. One of them was Castlevania. I'm pretty sure that those are really gory games. So if she's going to...
I remember playing Prototype. And, dude, there was so much violence in that. Like, you could rip people in half with giant claws that were, like, 5 feet long.
Jeez.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong.
She wants to complain about Doom, yet she's going to take a picture saying, oh, I'm a gamer. I have all these games.
Gears of War is, like, one of the top 10 goriest games I think ever created. Because, I mean, you could literally run up to somebody and chainsaw them to pieces.
Yeah.
I mean, that's not in every...
The point is that I'm pretty sure she bought all those games simultaneously in the same day and decided to take a picture next to it to look good.
Yeah. You what you're saying is you don't like that she was being hypocritical about it.
Yes.
That's true with pretty much every activist, though. in, like, most activists are hypocritical.
Yeah, most are.
They go with whatever story sounds the best.
I wonder, oh gosh, what was that? Never Windows thing just, okay, my Windows is asking me to free up storage space, but who cares? Goodbye. Okay. Yeah. Anyway, what were we talking about? Oh yeah, I was gonna say I think most activists don't actually care about what it is they're fighting for. Maybe that yeah. It could just be that they just want like money because they get paid every time they go to speak at places and stuff. Yeah. Like they make a lot of money from just going and complaining about things.
Yeah.
Which is basically what we're doing now, except we make less.
Or if you're me, you don't make anything.
Yep. So sad. I was just like, uh-huh.
Yep. That's life.
Poor boy. Poor little blonde boy.
A poor little blonde boy.
So, I guess something...
Did you just say you're a poor little blonde
boy? I am blonde, but I'm not poor.
Okay, hang on.
Oh, gosh, I just dropped something.
Okay, so, yes. Okay, never mind. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
I'm sorry. It's complicated. I got a lot of stuff going on right now. I'm just trying to do this one podcast. Maybe then my life will be complete.
Maybe then I can die happy.
Okay, are we on to like things we hate or things we like? I can't remember.
I think we're on things we hate, and okay. I haven't gone yet.
Okay, you go, Will. You go, Waffles.
So this is something I hate that I like. Do you guys watch Drama Alert on YouTube?
No.
No? Oh my gosh. Keemstar is like the worst type of person ever, but he makes funny videos.
You just sounded like somebody from like the Housewives shows. You just said ever. The worst kind of person ever.
No, but seriously, he is, like, the worst kind of person. Like, he's just disgusting.
A straight-up dirtbag.
Yeah, like, straight-up dirtbag. Like, the other day, but there was a report he did. He's, like, the TMZ of YouTube, kind of.
Okay.
And, I mean, I already don't like TMZ, but...
I don't get why.
But, anyways... So, like, he did a report on a YouTuber being racist, and then there was a stream that he was in where he was calling someone the N-word, and then told all his Twitter followers to go call that person the N-word. So, it's like, well, you're being hypocritical there. And then there was a thing where, someone said something about his daughter, who's, like, 6 years old, which is messed up to do. But the dude went crazy, and there was another reporter that... reported on like what was going down, and he sided with Keemstar, but Keemstar thought that he laughed at a certain point, so he like started like attacking the dude and got his he leaked the guy's Skype, so a bunch of people DDoSed him, and then he tweeted at the guy the guy's parents' address and said he was going to go pay them a visit, and just did like a bunch of crazy stuff.
Okay, so this is the guy you hate is doing all this bad stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. This sounds like a messed up dude.
It's messed up.
A
guy
with psychological issues, like a real Michael Myers type.
And he just feeds on people's lives being destroyed. Like, he loves it. It's crazy.
So he's a mega troll.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, I missed that jump. Okay. I was going to say something. What was I going to say about somebody I disliked? Oh, yeah. Okay. This isn't somebody necessarily I dislike, but more somebody I find really obnoxious and annoying.
Me?
No. You. It's Paris Hilton. Okay, get this right. There was an article, I read this, about Paris Hilton's dog has passed away at the age of 14. And I'm like...
pretty normal for a dog to do.
Yeah, and she's talking about how... I won't diss the dog. I'll just diss the fact that she's like the heir to like a multi-million dollar company.
Paris Hilton?
What?
Is that what you said?
Yeah. I said Yeah, Paris Hilton is the, yeah, that's what I mean. It's like, how is she this, how is she who she is? You know what I mean? Like, how is it you get to be that and you're the heir to a multi-million dollar company?
I don't know.
Maybe it's more maybe it's more like I dislike Paris Hilton's parents for just making it so that, like, okay, she gets... okay, for instance, okay, if I'm the owner of like a multi-million dollar company and I have a kid and I'm going to give my company to this kid one day, you can bet that I will do everything to make sure that kid has like the very best education and like is the smartest human being on the planet.
Yeah.
Because it's like you don't want like Paris Hilton running a company.
Yeah. You know?
Because like I saw some video. I don't know why I saw this or how I saw this, but it was like a Paris Hilton's reality show. And it was like her mom still makes lunch for her and stuff. Like okay. Basically, her parents do everything for her, and I'm just like, why?
How old is she? Like,
like she's like, I don't even know, like what, in her 30s at this point? Yeah. Probably.
It's crazy.
Okay, somebody else. Actually, I got one more. Somebody else I really dislike is Madonna at this point. Madonna. Okay, you know what? We were talking about age. Madonna's like 56 years old.
Yeah.
And still, through the use of plastic surgery and insane weird drugs, I think, tries to look like she's 20 years old and dresses like it.
It's weird.
And she, get this, I heard her say that one of her favorite activities was going to party with her daughter.
What?
I'm like, what weirdo are you? Like,
yeah.
Like, who does that?
That's pretty weird. Yeah, I like going out and getting hammered with my daughter, if you know what I mean. Going to the artist.
Like, yeah, it's like, who...
Or be like, oh man, if she wasn't my daughter, I know who'd be my wife.
That's a weird thought process. Man, if only she was my daughter, then I'd be married to Madonna. It's like, wouldn't you just think, man, I wish I was married to Madonna, I wish I was that girl's mother. Dude, that was so weird what you just did. Okay, by the way, who's timing this?
Skype is, and it's 56:08.
Okay, we'll go for a little bit. I think though we've been in the call though. Like I don't even know.
We were in there for a couple minutes before we actually.
Okay, so something Lion hates now, I think. Yeah, Lion.
Or Lion did the hate of the feminist girl.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
I think we're on likes again.
Okay, what do we like? Hashtag love.
Hashtag love.
Hashtag love forever.
Who's up?
Waffles, why don't you go?
Why don't I go? Something I will love forever. Well, movies in general.
Movies in general.
Like, I just love film. I think it's awesome.
Well, okay, you know what? That's cool. That's something to comment on, actually, that we should be thankful that we get as great movies as we do it to this point.
Yeah.
You know, like we're at this point where, like, okay, think about this. No other generation will be able to say they were at the point when Marvel started becoming a big thing.
Yeah,
you know, big, like, we've gotten to see presence. Like, for instance, all right, I was thinking about this about Star Wars, that, like, we are at the point, we're where we are right now. We get to see Star Wars for another... I think Disney has said either forever or the next 40 years there will be Star Wars movies. Jeez. Imagine when we're old and we all have kids and stuff like that. And we're like, kids, when these things first started, I was like 17 years old.
Yeah.
Like, imagine something like that, you know?
Yeah.
Like, could you... I just can't believe that.
It's that pretty crazy.
Insane.
We're going to be like... I remember episode 7 when it came out. And then they're going to be like, shut up, Grandpa, it's episode 47.
Yeah.
This is a whole 40 more movies.
It will be. Imagine that.
It's like...
Imagine that. Okay, for instance...
Where's Anakin Skywalker? Okay,
by the time that we're old, Finn and Rey will be old. And it'll be like the new episode 7, and then we'll be the parents that are going to see the movie, and we're like, I remember when they were young and they were the main characters of Star Wars. And
oh, that's going to be so weird. It's like a paradox. It's like, I know. I remember when they were young and then there were older actors that were young at one
imagine,
time.
Imagine that, though. Imagine if that's how all, like, forever, that's how life is. That's like weird. Our, like, the next generation and the next generation all experience that same thing.
Yeah. Can we just say for a sec, Disney has, like, such a big power in the movie industry right now, because they're the ones that help Marvel with their films, and then they're also the ones that are doing the Star Wars movies now.
Dude, I mean, just have a huge presence. I think we also have to think. There are a bunch of people who hate Disney.
Yeah,
but I mean, as an entertainment business, we should really be like, you know, Disney's pretty cool, seeing as how they're responsible for Marvel and Star Wars and like everything. You know, like all of this awesome stuff we love is kind of all thanks to Disney originally, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I'm just like, wow. Like, can you believe the person who's running Disney? Like, what it's
They're
like?
They're probably making millions and millions of dollars.
I just imagine this, though. Imagine being like, I own Disney. I own Marvel. I own Star Wars. And just being like, what do I do now with my life? Like, what do you do when you own, like, all that stuff? I don't get what you're supposed to do, you know?
Go crazy.
I guess you have to. I mean, it's... Like, okay, I get that there are a lot of people
Give away like, all your money and start over again.
But, okay, I get that there are a lot of people, you know, who are like...
Run it into the ground.
There are a lot of people who really hate rich people. I think that's wrong to hate rich people because it's like... Well, if you want to be that guy, then go do it. You know, you go think of an idea that makes you millions of dollars, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you go work hard instead of complaining about how you don't have money.
Yeah.
But it's like, okay, Mark Zuckerberg, mm-hmm. I don't think anybody should go hating that guy. Because that guy was smart. Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, all those guys are smart people who just happened, you know, they figured stuff out. And for instance, I don't think that Steve Jobs is like I don't think he's the creator of the iPhone. You know, like a bunch of other people invented the iPhone. He just said, okay, make a phone that has a touch screen, you can put all your music in it, and it can do all this other stuff. And then people were like, okay, and they made it. But he was the guy smart enough to come up with like
the ground idea. The framework.
And you know what? He built the company too.
Yeah. Like,
it's not easy just building a company.
Yeah, it's not.
He wasn't exactly in the easiest life in the world. I mean, he even got fired from Apple at one point. I mean, you know, that guy wasn't exactly a rich dude all his life. But it's, okay, I think it's the same thing with Donald Trump, though. Like, don't hate Donald Trump because he's rich.
Yeah.
I mean, and don't laugh. I'm just saying, though, that... You know, like you shouldn't hate Donald Trump because he's rich. I mean, he worked hard to make money. Like, I think a lot of people think these people just sit back and just sit and watch paychecks come in and play golf. Like, that's nothing that a CEO... I mean, being a CEO, I'm not saying that it's hard. Like, it's really, really hard, as hard as other jobs. I'm just saying that to build a company and maintain it in difficult times is not an easy thing to do.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah.
And, I mean, that's not one of the reasons I, myself, am not a huge Trump fan. It's not because of his money or anything. Some of the things he says is just like, why?
Yeah, I mean, and here's the thing. I think that most – here's the thing I don't like, though, is that people making Donald Trump the end of a bad joke. You know, like, I don't like the idea of the guy doesn't deserve to be respected in some way, you know? Because, like, he's done a lot, you know?
He does. I don't know if I want him as president, but I mean...
I mean, I can understand that. The reason I think that I said that he would be a good president is because I don't see anybody else being better right now. I see everybody else as being, like, meh. You know? Yeah. Like, okay, he's the only dude who's like, hey, you know what? Let's go defeat ISIS. You know? Like, he's the only person I've... Like, okay, Hillary Clinton hasn't... I don't get Hillary Clinton at all. I think she's insane. Marco Rubio, I don't know. I just think that guy is, I don't like him. He just doesn't seem like he has it figured out, you know? Like, I don't see him being the guy who's like, I am the man with the plan. Jeb Bush is kind of just insane and somewhat like he's just, have you seen the ads he's been doing?
Nah.
He's been doing some real crazy ads talking about, like, I don't even know. Like, he's not even being mentioned anywhere, though, now. Like, because he's fallen so low. Okay, Ted Cruz, I think, is so, like, okay, Ted Cruz doesn't even get along with the Republican Party. I don't think I want that guy as president. Who else is there that's... Carly Fiorina, I wouldn't mind. I think Carly Fiorina's would be a good choice, which is another thing. Feminists should not go around saying, hey, we want a woman as president, but not be like, hey, Carly Fiorina would be a good choice. It's like, it has to be Hillary Clinton, you know? But who else is there running for president?
Bernie Sanders.
Bernie Sanders is a socialist, so no. how are people like, okay, Bernie Sanders is an option. You're living in America. Like, where did you get that idea from? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that's like if, like, Vladimir Putin came over here and was like, I wish to run for president.
We fell far from the original topic.
Yes, we
did. Yeah, we did.
Okay, anyway. Let's continue back to what we were talking about. Okay, so who's has to talk about something?
I don't even know anymore.
I think it's still things we hate, and I think it's me now.
It was actually originally love, and I didn't get to go.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Things we love.
Yeah.
I really love macaroni and cheese.
Awesome. Okay, he's done.
Man, that was what I was going to say next round.
Because cheese.
yeah, cheese. Oh, boy. What's something that I love? Something that I really, in all of my life, have really, really loved.
I don't know. What is it?
I don't know. I'm thinking. okay. Will, you go ahead and go on, and then I'll go.
I already did what I love.
Oh, okay. I really love the fact that we are going to hopefully get a really good Batman movie.
With Batfleck,
yes,
as the actor. Yeah, I'm pretty hyped for that.
Yeah, I heard a bunch of people on the news talking about how it's going to be the worst Batman movie ever, Batman v Superman.
Yeah,
because of the idea of it. But I mean, I just listen. Even if it's a bad movie, it doesn't mean it's over for Batman and Superman. Like, they're going to... Okay, for instance, they've built that thing up way too much to just drop the ball immediately.
Have it fall.
Yeah, like, they're not going to be like, okay, that big list of movies that we're going to make, yeah, let's just all end all that. They're not going to do that. Like, they're going to go through with it. They've come this far.
Justice League.
Yeah, like, they're going to make Justice League and things like that. And it'll make a ton of money. It just has the name Batman will cause revenue to come there. I mean,
yeah.
See, that's why Disney's so smart, is because they realize the power of brands. The power of brands is the most powerful power in business.
I think I like, or I, what one thing I don't like, I mean, I'm obviously going to go see that movie because it looks awesome, but the one thing I don't like is the amount of destruction that is done in them. Because then it's like, well, how are they going to fix that all up? And then it's like, next movie, oh, it's all back to normal. Like, do you remember at the end of the new Superman movie, like, Metropolis was gone. Metropolis was wiped gone. From the face of the earth. And now it's like, oh, hey, it's
all
okay,
you know what I thought built was, back. You know what I thought was weird, though? In that movie, you remember when Superman comes out and the people start crawling out of the building, the destroyed buildings?
Yeah.
How did anyone survive any of that?
Yeah.
Okay, there was that giant dubstep cannon thing.
Yeah, that, like, forced everything into the ground.
Yeah, like, that literally disintegrated everything, every living thing in, like, a mile radius.
Yeah. Also, how come that thing could, like, pick up cars and, like, force them back down into the ground, but it never picked up people?
That is weird.
Because, like, I mean, if that's
magnetic
up,
force.
It probably...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that would make sense.
But then why, I guess the buildings have metal rot, like the metal.
Yeah, they would have.
Yeah. All right, something we hate now. I guess I'll go. Okay, something I really I don't necessarily hate this. I just dislike it greatly. Is Sword Art Online? Have you guys heard of that?
No.
Seen it? Okay, so get this. All right, Sword Art Online is an anime about a bunch of kids getting stuck in a virtual reality video game.
Okay, I think I've heard of it.
Okay, now here's the thing I dislike about it. All right, is that at the end of the first season, it goes from being this, you know, RPG VR game that's kind of cool to being a game about fairies. It is literally, I'm serious, every character in the game is a fairy.
That's a little weird.
And I'm like, why? Like, why would it, why? I don't like fairy fairy people.
As the yeah, like, characters. You had a good thing going, why'd
yeah.
you?
Yeah, it's like, and they finished the first game mm-hmm. by, like, the first half of the season. First season. And then, all right, here, get this, all right? So, second season is about this mysterious guy in this other video game that's like, imagine Counter-Strike, but mm-hmm. it's like an MMO. So which actually sounds kind of cool. But it's like a super competitive shooter game, and it's VR, so which makes it pretty cool. And so the main character has to go inside this game and find this guy called Death Gun, who is and his gun is called Death Gun. And his thing is that he'll, like, shoot a player with his death gun, and then they'll die in real life.
Wow.
So he's almost investigating how it is that can happen. And I won't spoil it or anything, but it's like, then they finish that up by the end of the first season, end first half of the second season. They finish that storyline. Then get this, the friend he meets in the gun game decides to then go over to the fairy game. And get this, then there's no stakes in the second half of the second half of the second season.
There's nothing that happens?
It's literally just them playing a game for the sake of playing a game. And it's like, why would I care?
Why do I?
You know, it's just a game at this point. Like, okay, get this. In the first little bit of story in the second half, is about them trying to save the game, because if they don't do this thing, then the game will end.
Yeah.
Forever. And it's like, am I supposed to, like, care? Because, I mean, it's just a game. I mean, if it was a game I was playing, I'm sure I'd care, but it's like, viewing this, you know
what
I mean?
It's just not interesting, I
mean? It's like, you can't have attachments to something that it doesn't give you a reason to have.
Yeah, it's not going to invest the viewer.
Like, there's no stakes at all in that. It's just a video game. And if we die, then, you know, we just wake up.
Come out of the virtual reality. Yeah.
We just wake up and we jack out of the Matrix and, yeah. And it's like, just keep it in the normal or first game where it was fantasy. And it was cool because it was like, the idea of it was that they were trapped in there for 2 years, all right? So imagine this, that people make lives in a video game. Like, they get married and stuff like that. So then you're like, does it count? Like, are these people really married, or is it just a video game still?
Video game.
You know, and it asks all these really interesting questions. But then it ends it by the first half of the first season, and it's like, why? It was going so cool.
And then you had to go and ruin it.
Yeah, and then it's like people, you know, it showed people how they all handled it. Like, some people, for instance, were player killers, and they just went around and killed players for fun. But they actually killed people. So if you die in the video game, you die in real life. So it's like the idea of, imagine if you knew that every person you killed in the video game was actually dead.
Now here's
the thing. The maker of the game is the only one who tells them that. So they don't necessarily know if they die or not. Which makes it even more interesting, because it's like, did I actually kill them? And should the characters actually feel bad about killing them? Or is it just, they just wake up? You know, like, it's the idea of, if they die, do they just wake up? You know, it's so interesting. And then it just all breaks apart. Just like, it's like somebody threw a rock at it. Like, it was a stained glass window, and somebody just threw a rock at it.
Yeah,
that was basically the equivalent of what happened, and I'm sad and it's horrible.
I'm sad and it's horrible.
Okay, somebody else say something they hate.
Lion, do you have one?
I really hate Tumblr.
Okay.
Now, do you hate Tumblr as the website, or do you hate the Tumblr people?
I hate Tumblr as the website.
Gotcha. Now, do you also hate, is this like just Tumblr or social media in general?
Tumblr.
He just really doesn't like Tumblr.
I guess it's a mix of me not liking Tumblr and the people who use it, because all Tumblr is known for is feminist social justice warriors.
Here's the thing I don't really like. I don't like social media really in general. You know, like, I don't really think that social media is in any way really a positive. I mean, it can be, but most of the time it isn't. You know, like, okay, for instance, Snapchat, Tinder, any one of the other various social media websites, it doesn't help anybody. You know, it's not like a positive thing for the world. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, I got something else I hate.
Yeah.
I got something else I hate. At the Ashley Madison website.
Oh.
Yeah. That's a whirlpool.
Okay, so I got to say, what did you guys think when that came out that they got hacked and that all those people's information got leaked?
Serves them right.
Okay, now here's the thing. I know we think it's a horrible website. By the way, I feel like there should be a law against a website like that existing. I feel like that should be a thing.
It'll exist no matter what, because, yeah. I mean, there's the deep web, and there's just really no way to stop it.
But, okay, so were you guys really, though, like, these people deserve to have their credit cards and all that sort of stuff ruined because they cheated on their spouse?
Well, then again, you know, it's not really our business to know who they're sleeping with.
I mean, but here's the thing. Okay, it's not our business, but I think it's the spouse's business to know.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I think
that they deserved it in the fact of the information leaking so that the spouse could see if they were being cheated on. Then that they did deserve it. But, yeah. I mean, I don't think anyone deserves their whole life to be
ruined. I will say this. Here's what I think. I think they should have leaked the names, but not the credit card
information. Yeah, that's what I think they should have done, too.
I think they should have just deleted all the credit card information and stuff like that.
The hackers take the credit card information, like, they don't need to put it out into the world.
Yeah, or, like put it away and hide it or something like that.
You know?
I mean, it's just, because, I mean, I think that those people are terrible people, but I would never say to anybody, like, I hope you never find a job or something like that, you know? Like, I always want, like, even if I don't like somebody, like, for instance, I don't necessarily like the person that Kanye West is. But I'm glad that guy found success, you know? Like, I would never say, I hope you just become a hobo and, like, you lose everything in your life that makes you happy. Like, no one should say that, no matter what you think of them.
Yeah.
You know? Like, because then you're just you're worse than them, because you're just doing something worse than the person you dislike. And that's why I hate people who go around and are like, the activists who are like, we need more equality, because it's like, wait, what was I saying before?
I don't even know where you just went.
Yeah, I was gonna make some kind of comparison to what I said, but then I forgot what I said. Anyway, okay, I've said like three things I hate. Lion, did you say something?
Yeah.
Okay, what did you say, Waffles? I don't think you said your thing.
I don't think I said anything either.
Okay, you can say it now.
I don't know. There's not a lot of stuff in the world that I like really don't. You know, there is something I don't like. I'll say this. It's
Nazis.
When people do nothing and everything is handed to them.
Like Paris Hilton.
More like the Kardashians. Like, what is your talent?
Oh, yeah.
Like, what makes you special type thing?
I think, though, that here's the thing. I think we've got to look at this. We're looking at this in the wrong way of traditionally how entertainment should work.
Yeah.
I think what we got to look at is that was someone who saw, hey, people can just be interested in my life in general.
Yeah.
And I think here's the appeal of Kim Kardashian is that she's like Paris Hilton, rich and can basically go do whatever she wants.
Yeah.
And it's sort of the idea of, I want to see what a rich person's everyday life is like. Like, what is it like to be rich without actually having any of the horrible consequences of dealing with a terrible family and, like, all the tragedy and stuff like
Outlash and things like
that. Like, I think that's the idea of it, is that it's getting to see what the experience of what it's being like. You know, like, for instance, Kim Kardashian basically has every materialistic thing that you could want. You know, like, she has Kanye West for a husband. She's got, like, I don't even know, like, it's millions of dollars from, like, and basically she doesn't have to, like, you know, she doesn't own a company. She doesn't have to, like, you know what I mean? It's like, yeah, it's like, just... it's like money with no attachments, you know?
Yeah.
It's
kinda like... What is she going to say when her kid asks her, how did you get famous, mom?
You know, that would be very interesting, though, when her son Northwest, which, by the way, the worst name you could ever name a child, Northwest.
Her son's never going to have to ask that question because someone's going to have to ask him it.
Like, how did you become famous?
Exactly.
I'm the son of Kim Kardashian.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
And Kanye West. But you know what I mean? Dude, imagine if Kanye West for a father.
I think that'd be fun, but horrible at the same time.
Like, okay, I could see, like, maybe that would be fun for, like, a day, like, a half a day. Like, okay, there's two sides of everything. A, you get to hang out with an awesome...
So you get to hang out with a crazy dad.
Crazy dad who's insane every single moment of his life. But I will say this, Kanye West, I think, does have talent. It's just not singing talent. I think that's what everybody forgets. Like, people are like, Kanye West can't rap at all. I don't think his talent is in rapping. I think it's just making sound that he's good at. Because if you notice, the songs are pretty good, but it's his rapping's horrible. But he can make an interesting sound for a song, you know?
Yeah.
Kind of the same thing with, like, DJs. Why are DJs popular? Well, it's because they can create stuff that you don't get to hear by it. Like,
normally.
And it's like stuff that, like, is completely original most of the time, you know?
Yeah. Like they make it from scratch.
Yeah.
Which is cool.
Yeah. I love Avicii, dude. Avicii's so cool, I think.
Yeah. I've been really into this guy, John Bellion, recently.
I've never heard of him. Is he a DJ? Yeah. Like a songwriter
dude? Yeah, he's like a songwriter DJ type guy.
Kind of like Avicii is most.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Cool.
Sort of like that.
Yeah. But yeah, at least has everybody said something that they love? Wait, Lion, I don't think you've said something, have you?
Something that I love?
Yeah. Or is it something that you hate?
I don't even know what
we're talking about. Okay, this is something that we love. What's something that you love?
I really love horror movies.
Horror really? Movies are good. Dude, have you guys seen The Thing?
Yeah, I saw
the original.
I loved that movie.
That's the one with all the, like, practical effects, right?
Yeah, yeah, and it's like, it's there, you know, they're it's got Kurt Russell and they're in the snow and there's a creature who can inhabit.
Turn into anyone.
Yeah, he can, basically he eats them and then can turn into anybody that
he has. It's not really a he.
More of an it.
It's an it, because they call it The Thing. I mean, it's just The Thing. But I love the ending of it, because the ending is such a... I will say this, the most important part about a horror movie, I think, is the ending and how you handle it.
Yeah.
Because there are so many ways to go horribly wrong.
And most horror movies open-end it at the end, like, leave it.
Yeah, and, well, it's, you gotta handle it in a way that it's closed, but it's also open-ended to where it makes sense as the ending makes sense, but...
There is an actual ending to The Thing, though. Where, like, I know how it ends with the two guys sitting in the room and they don't know which one of them, like, they both think the other one's the monster type thing.
Or neither one of them could be it. Because it's just that we don't see where they get out of the big burning building.
Yeah.
And it's just...
There's a comic series that follows it up.
Oh, really? Oh,
there was...
I'd love to read that. Huh.
I know in the movie, one of the actors confirmed it, too. There's a part, in, I think, where he, like, is making a Molotov cocktail, or one of the characters is... And at the very end of the movie, one of the characters picks up a bottle and drinks from it, but it was the bottle that the guy was using to make the Molotov cocktail, so it's The Thing, because it's drinking pure gasoline. Like, it's drinking pure things that a human would not be able to digest.
Wait, so when does that happen? When did you say that happens? Is that like in a deleted scene, or is that one of the actors?
I think that's one of the actors confirms it, because it's something weird. I was watching it. It was like 10 movies that have what you think are surprising endings, but really aren't.
Oh, okay. So I see. So it's like that one of the actors said, if you like, the director told me that this happens after the movie ends that isn't in the movie at all, but it's...
Well, it's half and half. Like, there is a scene where someone's making the Molotov cocktail, and there is a scene where the other actor is drinking from the Molotov cocktail.
Okay.
And then...
It got, like, deleted? Is that what it's supposed to be, that it got cut
out? I don't know if it got cut out. I think it was just something a lot of people missed.
Yeah.
Because it's just such a little thing. But
you're right, because they both drink a bottle of whiskey, I think is what it is. Or something, yeah. Or something like that. I think, I don't know. I mean, we'd have to go back and watch the movie. But
the actor says at the very end that he realizes that the other guy is the thing because he drinks from the bottle, and that there's a flamethrower just out of the camera's frame. Or something like that. Yeah,
the actor said. The thing is, though, that wouldn't have been as good of an ending. Because
that's the reason.
It's much better ending not knowing.
Not knowing. And that's the thing
is, because it's like, you really can't know. Like, it's the same thing. Have you guys heard the movie It Follows?
Yeah.
Where it's that kind of ending of, you never really know if it's there or if it's there not, or if it's just your imagination. Because once the idea is in your head, you can't just let it go. You know?
Yeah.
Like, it's there. Like, you will always be haunted in a way. I love monster movies that have an interesting monster rather than just slasher movies. Slasher movies, I want to see a really like well done slasher movie. Like, okay, Halloween is a really good well done slasher movie, but even so, I want an like really like spine chilling, but not like jump scare. For instance, Nightmare on Elm Street, horrible ending, because it's just like, they kill Freddy Krueger, but then he's back for no reason, and then jump scare, be it.
Yeah.
It's like, what did that mean? You know, like,
yeah, what was accomplished?
Yeah, it's like, I mean, of course the answer is, well, they want to set it up for the next one, so that way they can say, here's a reason why another, like, he's back, or whatever, even though they don't actually explain it. But, you know, like, I want to see an ending where it's like, I don't know, even the ending of Halloween isn't amazing, because it's just, what's the ending again? It's like where he shoots him, but then he goes out the window, and then he goes to look at him, his dead body, and he's not there. Is that just the ending?
I think that's how.
Horror games are also really amazing.
Horror games, I seriously.
The evil with.
I play horror games, though. I just can't.
The like, Evil Within will always be my like my most favorite horror game.
The Evil Within was fun, but really weird.
It looked
and left
really
you with
weird.
A lot of questions.
You gotta see. That's the thing, is that you gotta be careful with horror movies. I think in many ways, horror movies are the hardest to direct, because it requires a very delicate and precise touch.
Yeah.
To do it properly, you know, like, because otherwise you'll just mess it up. Like, okay, Friday the 13th. Those movies are like a romp. You know, those movies aren't supposed to be, like, Academy Award-winning movies.
Yeah, no.
You know, like, I think all horror movies should be, like, at the level could win an Oscar.
It'll be ready in about 5 minutes.
All right. Thanks. I'm going to have to go soon.
Okay. Well, we should be done with this pretty soon.
Yeah, we're about 1:30.
Okay, that's fine. I mean, it's a special episode because, you know, New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve. Woo!
It's not New Year's Eve anymore, but.
New Year.
It's like a day after New Year. It's a new year. But so, anything else that we want to talk about? Anything in general, just like broad, that we just wanted to talk about? Because this is basically just an excuse for us to get to talk about anything we wanted.
Not really. I'm pretty drained.
Yeah.
Same.
But for Halloween. I definitely want to do a Halloween podcast where we talk about either. Which would you guys want to do, a horror movie or just horror movies in general?
A horror movie.
I think a horror movie would be better. We could do maybe The Thing, because that's one of the best horror movies I think I've ever seen.
Heck yeah.
You know, like, I mean, what's one of the best horror movies that are out there? Halloween.
I want to say Scream, but that wasn't really scary at all.
We could say The Ring, but that's not a very good horror movie.
I haven't watched a lot of really
The Ring movies. Terrified me, though.
The Prometheus. Ring really...
The no. thought of The Ring terrified me.
The thought of The Ring, yeah, definitely. Same with It Follows. I mean, that was... They're both really scary ideas. Like,
guys,
that's why
guys,
I like
guys, the... guys, guys, guys. What? Prometheus.
No.
Yes.
No.
Are you talking about the prequel to Alien?
Oh, we could do Alien. We could do Alien, though. Alien is a good horror movie.
No, Prometheus. Prometheus.
No. It's a terrible movie. No.
Why is it a terrible movie?
Don't speak. like no.
Why is it a terrible
because
movie?
Because it's garbage. Because nothing like ever happens.
Plot holes.
And it's, yeah, plot holes, and it just doesn't matter because why should I care about any of those people that die in the movie? Why? That's the biggest question, though, for a horror movie that it most often fails to accomplish is what is the reason for caring about any of these people?
Yeah.
Like, okay, that's what Friday the 13th always messes up is it's just a bunch of kids who don't matter.
Yeah.
You know, like, they're not very interesting characters. They don't really do anything. They just kind of hang out and have fun.
Wait. There is talk, confirmation of Alien 5.
Well, they're making Prometheus 2.
Yeah, but that's what Ridley Scott's working on. Ridley Scott isn't working on Alien 5. Someone else is.
Okay, listen, let me tell you guys something. I think any series should just probably end when it reaches the fifth movie.
Yeah, I feel like eventually you're beating a dead horse.
Because if you made five movies, okay, I'll tell you this:
Friday the 13th made like nine of them.
No, if you've made five movies and they're all outstanding, then keep making them until people are like, this isn't good anymore.
Yeah,
you know, like Star Wars. Okay, Star Wars is a good example, but don't like Friday the 13th should not. Here's the thing, though. Friday the 13th's goal is to make 13 movies in total, and then they'll end them. So I think the next one is going to be the last Friday the 13th movie, which I guess, oh gosh, we might actually review that. It'll depend. It'll depend if we care.
Yeah.
So I guess that's a podcast, isn't it?
Yeah.
This was fun. I like doing this.
Talking about things and stuff.
Yeah, it's like anything, you know? Oh, by the way, one thing I want to talk about, this is like news stuff that happened. The new images of Doctor Strange, played by Benedict
Cumberbatch. Yeah, I saw those.
Those
Cumberbatch
look amazing. Those, I gotta say, he looks outstanding as Doctor Strange.
It looks like it'll be interesting, yeah.
And you know what's weird? He looks so much like a comic book character.
Yeah.
Like, it's on point with how ridiculous his costume. It's not like ridiculous in a bad way, but like comic booky. You know, it's like it looks, and it's got the collar that's like really high and everything. It's just like, yeah, that's Doctor Strange for sure. You know,
yeah, it looks cool.
Yeah, it does. So, everybody, thank you for listening. If you've made it to the end of this.
You're a champ.
Like, you are. You are a true
one
champion.
Free potato for you.
No, we can't do that because I'm pretty sure we have to fulfill that if we say that. So, no, that was just a joke. You don't get anything.
No. I will dispense potatoes.
Other than our appreciation, you don't get anything.
Yeah,
so anything you guys wanted to say to wrap this up?
I love you all.
Yeah, so, okay.
I can't beat that.
I should probably say this. Where should they find you guys at?
Just put my link in the description.
No, I'm not going to do just that. You have to say it. Say it!
Find me at my channel.
Link in the description for him. Any social media things you want him to follow you on?
I don't have any social media things, so not that popular.
Okay, well, you guys can find me at... You can find me at Cosmic Waffles Space TV on YouTube or kina.exe on Twitter.
Cool. Yeah. I am Teddy Jenkins, as always, your host, and you can find me at TeddyJYT on Twitter. Yep. That's nice. Me. That's the first time I've ever gotten to say that.
Really?
Oh, man, I had meant for us to have, like, an ad. Like, I was going to get us, like, an actual sponsorship in which we would have, like, a little ad. Like, one of us would read an ad.
Yeah.
Like they do on professional podcasts.
Yeah.
How cool would that be?
That would be pretty awesome.
And next week.
You see, the reason I'm not advertising my channel right now is because if you type in lion, you're not going to find anything.
That's very true. You should change it to something other than just lion. Like lion forever, hashtag love the lion. Longest.
You could change it to lion maker and get burned alive.
Or you could change it to Cecil the lion is dead.
Oh, gosh. No. That'd be even worse.
Dude, do I don't not, know much do hate fake, you get.
Do not make fun of my brother.
You,
my dead brother.
I can't believe people freaked out when Cecil the lion died. It was a lion.
There.
It was a beast. It was a predator.
Exactly.
It would kill you.
Like you.
Yeah, yeah. Like like an innocent teddy bear would rip your face off. Okay, you know what? We've been doing this forever. Thank you all for listening / watching. I am Teddy Jenkins.
I am Cosmic Waffles.
Yeah, thank you.
And I am Lion. Hear me roar.